My name is Rajiv Sridharan. Welcome to CNC Learning. In my video about working principle, I have explained about absolute and incremental encoders. In this video, we will learn about absolute and incremental dimensioning system.
Somebody in Russia is asking the way to New Delhi. The answer is travel towards south. Now the same question is asked by somebody in Saudi Arabia. The answer is travel towards east. Now when same question is asked in Sri Lanka, answer is travel towards north. Now when it is asked by somebody in China, answer is travel towards west. So for the same question, there are different answers because the answers are depending on the location in which it is asked. Now, with a minor modification, the same question is repeated. How to reach New Delhi from Mumbai? So, a person in Sri Lanka is answering, travel towards north. Now, the same question is repeated in China, but the answer is same, travel towards north, because the question is, how to reach New Delhi from Mumbai? The reference is fixed. So the answer is also fixed. A person in Russia also gave the same answer and the same with Saudi Arabia. This system is called absolute system. So there is an absolute reference from which the direction is taken. Reference is fixed to Mumbai. So this system is called absolute system. Now, in our previous case, different answer from different location. This is called incremental system because the direction is taken from the location in which it is asked. Now the same kind of system is used in CNC. Now let's see what is absolute coordinate system. G code used is G90. In some cases, instead of using G90, the coordinate address itself will be different. For example, instead of XYZ, UVW will be used for incremental. Now, what we are going to see is a system where the absolute coordinate system is defined by G90 G code. Now let's take a rectangular block of 50 mm width and 100 mm length. Now P1 is X0, Y0, P2 is X100, Y0, P3 is X100, Y50, P4 is X0, Y50. So all these coordinates are in absolute coordinate system because all the coordinates, the distance is taken from absolute zero. Now let's see incremental coordinate system, which is defined by G code G91. Same rectangular block. P1 is X0, Y0, it is already defined. P2 is X100, Y0. So here it is almost similar to our absolute coordinate point. Now P3 is x0, y50. Now the absolute coordinate for the same P3, you already seen it is x100, y50. Now incremental coordinate for P3 is x0, y50. So incremental coordinate is always with reference to your previous point. So now for P3, previous point is P2. So P2, now the coordinate for P3 is calculated from P2. P2 is taken as a 0 and P3, what is the distance in x and y? So in x-axis there is no distance, so it is x0, you can omit even. And in y-axis direction it is 50 mm. So that is why in incremental coordinate system P3 is x0 y50. Now P4. Now P4, how it is calculated? For P4, P3 is the reference. So P3, if P3 is 0, P4 would be x minus 100 and y 0, because in y-axis there is no distance. The distance is only in x, but in minus direction. And suppose the tool has to come back to original position, then P1 again would be x0 y minus 50, because in x-axis for P1 here the previous coordinate is P4 and the distance in y-axis is 50 in minus direction. X-axis there is no distance, so P1 is x0 y minus 50. Now you can see another difference. Earlier we said P1 is x0 y0 when the tool is already in that location. Now when the movement was from another location, this become like this. Now absolute coordinate system, say P1 in turning, P1 x is diameter and z is length. So x25 and z minus 7.5. P2 is x40, z minus 15. Diameter is 40 and distance is 15. P3 is x40, z minus 25. P4, x60, z minus 35. So these are the absolute coordinate system for turning. Now let us see incremental coordinate system. P1 is u0 w minus 7.5. So I have already mentioned that in some of the systems, instead of G90, G91, the coordinate will be used as UVW instead of XYZ. So anything which is defined in UVW is already considered as incremental. Now P1. For P1, x25, z0 is taken as a 0. Now, so P1 is in x direction, there is nothing, no distance. And W, that means in z direction, it is 7.5 mm. So P1 is u0 W minus 7.5. P2. Now P1 to P2, what is the distance? Incremental. So x25 to x40, 15 mm distance in diameter. So U is 15 and W is minus 7.5. 7.5 to 15. P3 is u0 W minus 10. So 25 minus 15 is 10. P4 is U20. So P2, P3 is same diameter 40, and then P4 is 60. So 60 minus 40, 20. So P4, U is 20 and W is minus 10. 35 minus 25. Now P0 is defined. U25 is a 0. Now let's see the application of incremental program. Now assume that you have a part with 5 holes, equal holes, and the 0 is defined as the center of center hole. Now the program for center circle G90, G0, X0, Y0. So that means with absolute coordinate system, the tool is positioned to X0, Y0. Then G91, G41, X25, F500. So tool is moving to this position with tool compensation active. Now, how it is G41 or G42? That will be decided by how the cutter movement is. So in this case, it is G03. So counterclockwise movement. So your tool is at left. That is why it is G41. Now G03, I-25, which we have already seen in previous class. Now, after your circle interpolation, the tool will be here. Then G91, X40, X-25. With this, the compensation will be cancelled and the tool will be positioned back in the center of the circle. Now, this program is fixed. G91, G41, X25, F500, then G03, I-25, then G91, G40, X-25. So this is true for all 5 holes. Now this G90, G0, X0, Y0 is the center coordinate for your first hole, that is center hole. Now for doing bottom left hole, first you need to position your tool in center of the circle because your subprogram is defined with center as center of the circle. Now G91, G41, X25, F500, G03, I-25, tool is moving like this, and then G91, G40, X-25. So for bottom right hole, that means this hole, again G90, G0, X100, Y-50. So you can notice this and this, there is only difference in the X coordinate. So now with this bottom left hole with this program, bottom right hole with this program. So in effect, if you see, there is no much difference. Now only you have to define your circle center. Now one care which is to be taken. Now assume that after running this program, when you start your next hole, you forgot to mention G90. So this also will be treated as G91. What would be the result? Bottom left hole positioned in center of circle, then movement to X25, then G03, I-25, then G40, X-25. So now after doing this, suppose you forget to mention G90, what will happen? Your tool is after cutting G03, your tool is positioned back. Now, instead of going to this location, what will happen is the next command is X100 Y minus 50 with this zero, because if you do not mention G90, the previously active command in the same group will be considered. So in this case, when you did this, your last command is with G91. Now, if you do not cancel it by G90, then this code would be active. So in this case, it is incremental. Now, what will happen? Your tool is here already. Now, instead of going to this position, next hole will position at X100, Y minus 50. So somewhere around here, you'll be positioning and then doing the circle. So which will be a disaster. So that is why whenever you are using a incremental command and make a program using incremental coordinate system, you have to be very careful. Once you define incremental coordinates, immediately you need to cancel it with using G90, that is absolute coordinate system. Application in turning. So you can do the repeated profiles, like now what we have seen in milling for doing circular interpolation at different points. In turning also, if you have repeated profiles, say you have a big shaft and every 100 mm you have got some undercut profile. So you can program one and the other programs can be called using subprogram, or you can position it directly in the program. Another application in turning is adjusting the taper of OD, ID or any shaft. How this can be done is, you say you make a 50 dia bar of length 100 mm. You measure the diameters at both extremes. Now, if you find that the second extreme, that means your left side, is showing say 0.1 mm undersize or oversize, accordingly you can adjust the taper. Say assume that the diameter is oversize at 100 mm length. So the adjustment in taper would be u minus 0.1. So the 0.1 which is going plus will automatically get adjusted. Another usage is retract. Say you have cut one diameter, say 50 diameter is cut, then you want to retract it by 2 mm. So instead of calculating what is the new coordinate, you can directly give u 2 and w 1. So that means 2 mm in x and 1 mm in z will move using incremental coordinate system. So for programming test, there are some free templates available in cnclearning.com. So all those programming resources you can download free of charges.
I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have liked it, press like. Subscribe the channel for more such videos. Click the bell icon for getting notified on new videos. I will come with more videos like this. Bye for now.